Letter to Lady Cynthia Asquith. When I drive across this country, with autumn falling and rustling to pieces, I am so sad for my country, for this great wave of civilization. 2,000 years which is now collapsing, that it is hard to live. So much beauty and pathos of old things passing away, and no new things coming. This house of the Otterlines, it is England. My God, it breaks my soul, there England. These shafted windows, the elm trees, the blue distance, the past, the great past crumbling down, breaking down, not under the force of the coming birds, but under the weight of many exhausted, lovely yellow leaves that drift over the lawn and over the pond like the soldiers passing away into winter and the darkness of winter. No, I can't bear it, for the winter stretches ahead, where all vision is lost and all memory dies out. It has been 2,000 years, the spring and summer of our era. What then will the winter be? No, I can't bear it, I can't let it go. Yet who can stop the autumn from falling to pieces when November has come in? It is almost better to be dead than to see this awful process finally strangling us to oblivion, like the leaves off the trees. I want to go to America, to Florida, as soon as I can, as soon as I have enough money to cross with Frida. My life has ended here. I must go as a seed that falls into new ground. But this England, these elm trees, the gray wind with yellow leaves, it is so awful of being gone from it altogether. One must be blind henceforth. But better leave a quick of hope in the soul than all beauty that fills the eyes. It sounds very rhapsodic. It is this old house, the beautiful shafted windows, the gray gate pillars under the elm trees. Really, I can't bear it. The past, the falling, perishing, crumbling past, so great, so magnificent. Come and see us when you are in town. I don't think we shall be here very much longer. My life now is one repeated, tortured, volley, volley, volley.